Penultimate round. Next to last round. It's Thursday. We're heading to Loretta Lynn's, the ranch. Getting everything packed up. I've got my my bikes. We're gonna go get Colin, and we're gonna drive about halfway tonight. Meet up with the Kneffs, Dave, Cooper, and Adam. Camp somewhere in a parking lot tonight, and then finish the trip off tomorrow. Check this out though. There's the winter dog. We've got some freshies for this weekend, just in. The hand up, I don't know what these are called, the pineapple gloves, or if you know, the swinger gloves, call them that way. We're gonna rock those this weekend. It's gonna be fun. It's about 5:30 p.m. on Thursday. We head down, this race is hot, this race is humid. This race isn't a lot of fun, if you ask me. Last year it was just a nightmare. Everybody had mechanicals, it rained. I don't think they're calling for rain this time, but it's like 95 degrees, so it's gonna be a doozy. Time to hit the road. It's 1:35 in the morning. Got about 45 minutes left.
That's tragic.
Dude, it says it's 1:40, it's 2:40.
No, it's ready. You skipped the time.
I don't like the John ones, bro. It's too, they're too thick. Gotta get Colin likes roughies in his dip.
Oh yeah, the hell of a good dip. That's in the fridge.
Get some athletic.
Dave, how many shorts did you bring for this trip? Just those?
Hand up, baby.
All right, so now we're resorting to Walmart.
Ben Hogan.
Try these on, baby. Seriously, Doug, that's what
you're doing with?
With a black?
No. Let me see that thing. Less talky, more coffee.
You didn't get that on video, did you?
I don't know, Doug.
Not at all.
All right, race day, Loretta Lynn's. Yeah, it's gonna be hot. At least it's dry this year. New course sections should be super fun. And yeah, we're just gonna get our hydration going, make sure everybody's ready, and then yeah, prep it and let's get at it.
You heard it first.
Cream of sugar? Adam, you don't know how to do this either. Get over here and learn.
I don't.
I'm gonna be broken inside the trail and you're gonna have to help.
Races. I don't work on bikes.
No way, man. I got food in my mouth.
Welcome to my crib.
Welcome to my crib. So what we got here is this deep dog bunk.
Right?
Got a shitter that don't work.
Let me bring you back here where Paul sleeps.
This is Paul's headquarters right here.
Look here.
This thing makes weird noises all night. Gurgling, sucking.
Hey, where's the other
Paul?
The other who?
What we got in the fridge?
Oh, the fridge. Well, let me tell you what we got in the fridge.
Never go anywhere without milk and eggs.
Period.
Got some leftover stuff from the house. It's probably 6 or 7 days old. Ain't eating that. Just took it so the wife didn't yell at me. Got some water. And then thousands of grams of sodium right here.
Some Jimmy Dean's meat lovers. That's what Paul eats. Paul, did you pick that up?
Pancakes and sausage.
What else? Broke this shit last night.
So we came over to see what old Charlie Mullins was doing, and we ran into this guy, old Justin Brayton, coming out to hang out with us. So oh, yeah. you're racing today in the XC1 class, huh?
Yeah, it'll be fun. Just came out. Really never been to one of these, so obviously a huge crossover from like supercross and moto to e-bike and the mountain biking world, and obviously been friends with Charlie for a long time, and we used to race bikes together quite a bit, and not even close to his level anymore, but it's fun to see all the success he's having, and yeah, and to come here to Loretta Lynn's, where I, you know, really grew up coming to every year, and hadn't been here in 20 years, so kind of cool to drive in and see familiar faces and familiar roads and kind of get those nerves going again, you know, from when I was a kid, so.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, I love everything bicycle, so excited to be here.
Yeah, it's cool because seeing more, you know, guys that are true professional athletes like you, and you've got Charlie and Nick, and the big misconception, like, well, we get, you know, back home, or people are like, oh, isn't that cheating? Is, you know, you get help, and but then you have true high-level pros like you out. What, I mean, did you kind of have that misconception of it when you first saw it, that like, maybe it's not for me, or?
You know, I never did, but I can see how people would, for sure. I spend the summers most of the time in Iowa, where I grew up, and like my family and friends there aren't that educated on bikes, and I had a couple bikes back there with me, and they kind of thought the same thing, like they just didn't think you'd get a workout, and they thought totally different after they rode it around. And I like it. I think you can get as hard of a workout as a regular bike,
for sure,
and the speeds are just a bit higher, but then you have the different settings you can try, and there's so many different options, and I love it. It gets new people into cycling. There's friends of mine that typically I would never really ride with, or they wouldn't even want to go riding. Now they're riding, and I really think, you know, I've witnessed a lot of people, really bicycles change their life, and now I think it's going to be another, you know, times two or three of that, getting people into riding, and just think
no
it's
doubt.
A cool deal.
Awesome, man. Well, good luck today.
Oh, thanks for having me.
Are you ready? Here with Adam Mayhew from Fairmont, West Virginia. Last year's overall amateur champion. This year, Adam's moved it into the XC1 Pro class. Adam, tell us about that transition to the XC1 class. What's it been like? And what do you got to do to elevate your training game to run with guys like Charlie Mullins and Nick Mack?
You know, first thing is, you know, last year, although it was the amateur class, there was some really fast guys, super talented. It was a tough, gritty season. You know, it went down to the last race. We had a three-way battle, winner takes all, you know, between Cannon, Kniff, Connor Karkowski, and myself, you know, just working hard throughout the season. Stay fit, watch the diet, spend as much time you can on a bicycle, and, wrapped up the championship last year. And then this year, moving into XC1, fortunate enough to get that opportunity with the team. It's been great. Really happy with the results, the talent, though, and the caliber of racers, you know, Charlie, Nick, all those guys are super fast, and, just trying to find my place in that class, you know, I think some of it's mental, right, you know, you left so, you know, on such a high note last year, and then you come into this year, and, you know, you're not performing like you want, but, you know, we're still in it, and we're going to finish this out and having a lot of fun. And for training, team rides on the weekend, ride as much as I can. You know, balancing, you know, typical 9-to-5 job, two kids, you know, the list that my wife provides on a weekly basis, and then, trying to ride as often as you can. That's the key.
And is this something you do with your family, Adam? Oh. Like, is this with the kids, with the wife? I mean, how's that?
Yeah, other than this race, they're always with me, and it's, to me, that's part of it. You know, a lot of work goes into that for all the families and all the, you know, all the parents that are here bringing their kids. I mean, everybody knows the effort that goes into that. But once you're here and in the atmosphere with all the fans and the people, and it provides such a great experience with, you know, for a family, you know, being here camping, hanging out with the kids. GNCC does an awesome job of, you know, promoting the STACYC races and getting the kids engaged. And it's an awesome environment.
All right. Well, that's it from Adam Mayhew from here at Loretta Lynn's Ranch.
Oh, come on.
I can tell that.
Come on. Just get it out.
So,
you're the champ, dude.
It doesn't have to be first drive. I'm just going to ask you one simple question. Tell me how much fun this is. What do you enjoy about doing this? Why do you like it?
Probably because I'm light and I can
You're talented on a bike. You've got the feel. You've come.
What's the most fun thing about it? What do you like the most?
Downhills.
Winning? You like winning?
Oh, yeah.
You like the downhills? You like jumping?
I like it all.
All right.
Especially the uphills.
Okay.
The climbs. You love the climbs.
So I hear you like climbing hills.
That's right.
You are a climber. Well, how do you climb? Like, what is it that makes you climb a hill so well?
Probably because I'm like 90 pounds.
Power to weight ratio, right?
Yeah.
Junior trail boss. Come on, boss.
These are challenging times, and we must all be all alive on turn number one of the stakes of Cold Shot. And the top athletes in all over the world get ready to go in 10 seconds! And we are off and rolling for that EMTB North American Championship.
Tech results, Michelin World Wind Machine, number 26, Cannon Canep.
That's a wrap on Loretta's.
The FIM North American Championship. Man, I'm going to be honest. I was not looking forward to this event leading up to it. Last year was miserable. It rained. It wasn't fun. So I think I had that in my mind. I was not looking forward to it. After the event, I'm home. It's Sunday evening. One of the most fun events that not only of this year, but I've ever had. Awesome, great camaraderie on the way down, as you could see. The turnout was strong, but man, the quality of the turnout, the people that were there. I mean, you had Ned Overin, Justin Brayton, just legends that were that came out to race. It was really cool, and team did well. Ashley got fourth in the women's class. Cooper has kept his undefeated season live. Colin had a gnarly battle for the lead. He ended up getting second. Really cool things that I think will stick with some of the guys just for forever. Adam Mayhew, our XC1 guy, and he battled with Justin Brayton and passed Justin Brayton. Like that's the cool thing about this sport. Like world-class athletes getting to say you rubbed elbows with those guys, and in this case, he beat them. It was just, yeah, it was a good day overall. I got sixth, best result of the season. I did not see that coming. So really, really good. We've got one more race left. Look, this season's winding down, but my duty as the team owner, like taking the athlete hat off and the boss owner hat back on, my job's just starting for next year. I had some really good meetings with some sponsors, some potential and current sponsors about next year. And, you know, had some really conversations with sponsors. Things are looking great. We got one more race to go. The Mountaineer in Beckley, West Virginia, another home race for us. We're going to end the season on a high note. Can't wait. We'll see you there.
Tape.
So we're at the final round. It is it's 9-11. They shortened our season up by about a month this year, which is nice. It doesn't get as dark on us. So man, perfect weather. It's just a great weekend. This facility in Beckley, West Virginia. We're at the summit at Bechtel Reserve. It's a Boy Scout camp. $1 billion facility. It's immaculate. And the trails here are fun. Everybody's having a good time. Yeah, there's a couple championships on the line for us. We've got Colin in the senior, the 40 plus class. He has an opportunity if things go his way to potentially wrap up a title. Gavin Garlitz in one of the youth classes, the 13 to 17 year old, I believe.
There's a three-way battle. He's actually got more of the upper hand, but it's between him, Mitch Hawkins, and Talon Hawk. So that'll be a really fun race to watch. Obviously, we want our guy to ride, but all those kids are really good kids. So, it's good, man. I think we had a really great season. We're talking to some people to potentially join the team next year. We're re-signing riders. Now's an exciting time for me. It's where the work starts. We start trying to renew our deal with all these guys and bring on, you know, something to try to make the team bigger and better next year. And I'm looking forward to a good day today. And then we're gonna have a really good celebration dinner at the end of today. The Fishers have made an awesome spread for us. So yeah, we'll finish strong and go into the off season.
Are you aware of how tight it is on that?
Yes.
The 12. I mean, that's insane.
Yeah,
and then you, I think we have this figured out, right?
Colin's
got to win. All you got to do is ride your race and win, right? And let whatever happens happen behind you. Listen, this is a race where a lot can happen. You know, that's a technical nasty section down there, and it's only going to get worse as this race goes on.
For world number one, the XC1 Pro EMTB here at the Rocky Mountain ATV MC Mountaineer GNCC.
Colin Dearman, a third place finish out here in the Senior 40 Plus. Every time I talk to you, I think to myself, Colin was there on day one at the John Pinton, a few years back. And you, how much has this changed over the last couple or few years now?
A lot. Tracks are completely different now. You know, they're giving us a lot more bicycle-only tracks, which is awesome, keeping us off of those the deeper four-wheeler ruts that are really difficult. And a lot more people. And the competition is super stiff.
That's good.
People are going fast.
That's good, man. Well, talk to us about today, man. What did it take to finish up here in the top three?
I mean, today was a tough day for me. I trying to battle with Ian all year. I needed to, you know, be ahead of him today, and he had it. You know, he was going real fast, but just tried to keep him in sight, and I had no idea that there was another rider in front of him. Just kept my head down, man. There was a lot of tricky sections that, you know, you really had to be careful to stay upright, because that was gonna lose you a lot of time as soon as you went down. So pick smooth lines through the rocks and fast lines on the bicycle specific stuff. It was a super fun course, and really enjoyed it.
Well, congratulations to you. Who do you want to thank out there?
Man, I'd like to thank Luke Nessler at Impact Results. Man, could not have done this season without his help. Also the folks at Michelin. Again, you know, the tires were super confident, inspiring. So it really makes a difference going into sketchy terrain when you're confident with your tires. And the Michelin tires that we've been running all year have been awesome. I'd like to thank all the guys at Walmsley Cycles. I have yet to have any mechanicals. Allowed me to stay on the box all year at every round, so I was really consistent. And the Jack Rue Insurance Centers, Arma, Hand Up Gloves, man, really everybody that supported us, it's just been awesome. I appreciate it. Thank you.
There you go. Make some noise. Third place finisher, Colin Dearman. Gavin Garlitz. I've been calling him Gartlets since NOM. Dude, talk to us. A second place finish today.
It was pretty good. I had a second place start. Just tried to keep a steady pace. I knew all I had to do today to keep the national championship was finished one behind Talon, and just kept it right there with him the whole race, and just glad to come in right behind him.
Well, solid day, man. Congratulations on a heck of a season. Who do you want to thank?
My mom, my dad, my sister, Impact Media Results, Luke Nessler, the whole team, Michelin Tires, Walmsley's, and just everybody else out there.
There you go. You guys make some noise for Gavin Garlitz. Coop, first place, dude.
Yeah.
Tell us about the ride, man. What did it take to get out in front, snag the win?
I got off to a first place start and got pretty messed up in that rock guard and played catch up from there.
But it paid off. That hard work paid off. Get the first place, feeling good?
Yes.
All right, well, solid job, dude. Who do you want to thank out there?
Mom, Dad, Impact, Michelin, Walmsley's, Arma, Insurance Centers. That's it.
Who's on FaceTime right there?
That's my mom.
That's mom. Hi, Mom. How are you? Good to see you. All right, you guys make some noise for Cooper Knapp.
Tell me about your season, and what's it feel like to win the championship, Gavin?
Well, to start off, this is my first year ever racing e-bikes for a full season. First race was rough, came off with just a DNF, and then second race surprised myself with the win. Second win, just knew I was coming into these last couple rounds. Just had to stay close to town and just had a blast doing it with this team. It was a great year.